happens when our gut goes out of order. As I shared with you in the beginning, we get diseases like hyperacidity, constipation, irregular metabolism, indigestion, IBS, weight issues, fatty liver, all of that happens. You know, very interestingly, yesterday I had a patient, right? I won't name. And we had got her genetic test done because her whole cardiac parameters and family history was very bad, and she could not explain why it is, because she was a very regular, in her lifestyle. She used to take care of her health, very successful, happily married, no stress. And I had told her a month back when she'd come to me that let's get your genetic test done for detoxification, because this is critical. We should know why, you know, this is happening in your family. And we got a genetic test done, and we were discussing it yesterday, and I showed her that, you know, your liver phase one detoxification is not happening. Phase two is not happening at all. And you know what she says? Doc, I have something to share with you. I said, okay, tell me, what is it? She said, you know, Doc, about 2 years back, I was admitted in a hospital and I was very unwell. And the doctor saw my liver test and liver ultrasound and said that I have a stage three, grade two, grade three fatty liver. And they asked me, do you drink? And my husband said, no, she doesn't. And then she said it was a big problem for my family. For almost a month, you know, they used to keep asking me and advising me, don't drink, don't do this, don't do that. So both of us smiled and we said, now you have an answer. You can show this report and say why you have fatty liver when you are not even an alcoholic, right? And you know that now that 40% of us have fatty liver even without drinking alcohol. Yes or no? Yes, right? And this is one of the reasons. So once this happens, and with these diseases, we keep on living. Why do we keep on living? Not that we want to live. First, we think, khud theek ho jayega. Second, we go to the doctor and the doctor gives us some medicines. We take them for a while. A lot of us keep taking antacids and laxatives for a long time. And that's the way of life. We sometimes go to an Ayurvedic doctor or homeopathic doctor, kuch ghar ke nuske, and that's where we are, right? After a few years, what happens? Symptoms of sinusitis, asthma, allergy, atopic dermatitis, dyspnea starts to happen. Body aches and pains start to happen. Why? Because gut microbiome has got so much deranged now that all these symptoms start, you know, showing up in our body. And this is not all. If this continues for some time, hormonal imbalances set in. Therefore, infertility at times happens. So very interestingly, very, very interestingly, in the first batch of our gut health, right? We had this girl who joined and who had maximum questions in the beginning before joining the program. But at the end of the program, where she is saying, even if she is forced to eat gluten in her lifetime, she will not. Do you want to know why did she make this bold categoric statement? So what happened was, after 3 weeks of elimination, in the fourth week, when she added gluten, she gained 2.5 kgs in 2 days. And she was like, ma'am, no, this can't happen. I lost 4 kgs in 2.5 and I've gained back in 2 days. I cannot tolerate it. I will not have gluten. But why did she do that? She did it because her body was reacting to gluten. And therefore, she was intolerant to gluten. And therefore, she was having inflammation inside whenever she used to take in gluten. And you know, all these diseases are inflammatory diseases, friends. Even for thyroid, 40% of us who have thyroid have Hashimoto's thyroiditis, and that means that antibodies are raised. And type 1 diabetes, in PCOS, in adrenal fatigue, all these diseases, this problem happens. And as I told you early on, when leaky gut happens, there are these particles which are released in the blood. Our immune system thinks they are the outsiders attacking us. And that is when what happens is they start producing antibodies And all these autoimmune diseases like lupus, irritable bowel syndrome, Hashimoto's, Crohn's, rheumatoid arthritis, vitiligo, psoriasis, urticaria happen. And this can also lead to cancer in some cases.